Hello, my beautiful congregation. How are you on this fine night? I am currently, blocking out everything ever, because it's election night. What you're here for is this video. I've been getting requests for this a lot. It won the poll, and also I reacted to his newest album, so it only makes sense to backtrack. Today, I am here at the reaction table again to listen to The Human Condition by John Bellion. Now, this is an album I'm quite familiar with, actually, because this is the album he was touring for when I saw him open for 21 Pilots. So I have heard a few of these songs, and there may be some that I have heard that I forgot about. Before we get started, if you have any suggestions for future reactions, drop them in the comments. I do see them, and I try to find the ones that get the most requested by separate people, and this one, you guys wanted it, I'm intrigued, so it's a perfect blend. So let's just jump in. So I've heard the first three tracks on this record, and I am very familiar with them, so we're just gonna breeze through the first three, because it's not really a reaction. So, I'll include them in the video, but, and if there is something new I notice, obviously, I'll keep it in the video. But as far as I know, I'm pretty familiar with the first three tracks, so we're just gonna breeze through them all, you know, let them play, because I know them, and then I'll meet you at the start. I like that. Damn. I will say it gets a little repetitive after, like, the lack of change. Like, the first minute felt real short, and it's only been a minute since that first one was done, and it feels like it's been a few now. I feel like I'm in, like, purgatory right now. Nothing happening. It's real calming. Billie Eilish vibes. What's with the Billie vibes? This is before Billie was even, like, Billie. Yeah, this one won me back. It was losing me for a little bit. It won me back.
We just need a night like this, yeah.
Oh, there's so much nostalgia in my heart right now.
Take me back to ninth grade shit, yeah. Just like me,
every time that every time that comes in, I get hyped.
Take me back to ninth grade. We'll hook up in my backseat and let my best friend drive.
Those harmonies and that guitar. God. Yeah, bar right now.
I call your name, you look right through me. You're the reason I'm alone and must have been. But that shit's broken. That shit's broken.
Another one of those purgatory vibes.
Now you know it. That I'm at an all time.
AJR vibes right there for sure. Oh god, yeah. Welcome to the Neo Theater. Come on. still AJR vibes with that one. That's the equivalent to like the
go!
Like, same shit. It's got the same effect, is what I mean. Solid first three tracks. 80s Films is like the top dog for me right now, gotta be honest. But there is, I believe, 11 more tracks. So that could easily get passed up. But I have not been bored yet. I mean, he is the same, almost did, but then it came through with that like purgatory Billie Eilish switch up. And it's been uphill ever since. You know, he did say he thought he peaked in high school, and she said no. So we never fucked in high school. So maybe that's a sign that he's like, this song's real good. This one's like crispy. So I'm gonna put it as track two to make you think it's all downhill from here. Wrong. It only gets better, actually. It gets better, as a matter of fact. You think this is the best song on the album? Fucking psych, nerd. Get out. Weenie Hut Juniors is across the street. Take your change and your toys. Pack up. Go get a milkshake. Come on. I can't fuck on milkshakes, though. Milkshakes are good. And this next song is called New York Soul Part 2.
Push me down the Hudson and turn on the radio. Long Island's owner smiling cause my soul is fine.
Holy shit.
I did everything for New York.
I'm not gonna ignore that, like that wasn't brilliant. And his bass too. But look at that intro. Whoa. If that doesn't come back, I'm gonna be really disappointed. If that's a one-time thing for the next, like, 4 minutes, I'm gonna be so mad. That deserves bigger spotlight. Let's see.
Yeah. New York, Irving, California, back Brooklyn up in his bag.
There's that rapping.
The with the Bronx, he kept in love with your man.
This got like a classic hip-hop feel to it.
You understand what I rustle up in the West, cause my reach is Kevin Durant. Records are very pop with a pocket deeper than sand. Adjust the position, Sam Cook, Billy Joe, Steely Dan. Changing the fucking spectrum, I need you to understand. Like I took the fall for some drugs, I've been nominated for Grams.
Grammys. I've been nominated for Grams. Grammys. Yeah. This honestly sounds like Wallows to me. That switch up is a little like rocky. That's it, from like that beautiful chorus to this like hip hop beat. The transition from that and the two is kind of, it doesn't really match up. Like, they're just so contrasting vibes that without a very smooth flow into it, it's kind of like, okay. What's gonna happen? They always got some like cool part at the end.
Yeah. Let me give the kids just a little help.
See? That's what I was talking about there. I said it and he did it.
Explain a bunch of millionaires that killed themselves. So you can take me off your women's shelf. I got different vision, I'm bringing help. I know the demons in the room will say it's more than I can chew, but now all I hear is the dinner bell. I need a family that loves me right. Don't need a chain, don't need a club at night. I had a conversation with an angel, she told me I'd see death if I stayed away from the party life. Dropped off in the land where the artists play, where God's way is the hardest way. Told myself I'm keeping my faith, if it cost me my reputation to take it, I'd give it all away.
Damn. This got like mad emotional. Okay, but that hook and that song, that's a hitter. It's weird to talk about that song. Because it's like that beautiful ass like melodic hook into the hip hop verses. It's so different. It feels like I'm talking about two different songs. And honestly, that's not a bad thing. I do wish there was a little bit of a smoother transition before the last one, but that's just like nitpicky shit for me. Yeah, this is track 5. This song's called Fashion.
I hit 'em with the boots in July, bitch, I don't need snow. I gotta go bigger. I gotta go bigger.
What?
5,000 on a coat, cause it's fly. No, I don't speak broke. Still, I gotta go bigger.
What?
Fucking go bigger. There's an aching, there's a hole in my chest, it's amazing.
I get it now.
The crown of a king doesn't change me. It's amazing. Baby, that we all want, we all need fashion. Baby, that we all want, we all need fashion. Have I lost control? A voice says I might need my soul.
Whoa.
But that's when I remember that we all want, we all need fashion. Lost in it, living life through a phone. Now it's all I know.
Jesus.
I gotta go bigger.
Oh my god, I get it now. It wasn't satire,
I gotta go
okay.
Bigger.
I mean, no, it like was satire.
Yeah. Ooh. $5 million males insecure, stuck in high school mom. Still, I gotta go bigger. Fucking go figure. There's an end. It's still her. Baby, that we all want, we all need.
That's interesting.
Fashion. Baby, that we all want, we all need. Fashion.
Bringing in a beat? Okay. I've noticed a lot of these songs have like a little ending part that's different from the rest of the song. Getting why this album is called The Human Condition. There's a lot of, like, hold on, He Is the Same is about, like, bums, pretty much. Like, people that don't, like, grow up, you know? And then 80s films is just straight nostalgia, something that everyone fucking goes through. Everybody knows what nostalgia is. I'm at an all-time low. Come on. New York Soul, he's talking about New York and shit. Obviously, it's like I said, it's on the title. But he's talking about the place that he's from. And a lot of other celebrities, fashion. What I got from that is like, the bigger he gets, the more he's expected to flaunt it. Or want to be better, or not better, want to be bigger. And it's like, oh, I got this money, I got this success. I need to just to throw it all away on material things. And that was executed in a really unique and beautiful way, because a lot of songs like Beautiful People by Ed Sheeran, you know, that's got like the beat of a song on the radio, that honestly kind of reminded me of Turning Out. Straight up. That came out of nowhere with those fucking belting notes. I love that kind of sound from him. Dude has got a great voice. Straight up. That's up there with 80s films. I don't know if it quite beats 80s films, but it's up there. It's right next to it. Oh my god. We're already at the middle right now. I think. These are like the middle. Nope. The middle two are after this song. This is track 6. It's called Maybe I Decay.
Yeah.
why I get paranoid when I'm high. I wonder why I say yes to everyone in my life. I wonder why I can't run that fast in my dreams.
That guitar work is fucking awesome.
I wonder why I feel short when I know my money's tall. I wonder why I miss everyone and I still don't call. I wonder why I can't run that fast in my dreams. Although, I guess if I knew tomorrow, I guess I wouldn't need friends. I guess if I never fell, I guess I wouldn't need grace.
Jesus!
I guess if I knew his plans, I guess he wouldn't be gone.
Oh my god.
So maybe I don't know. Wonder why I feel hopelessness when I watch the news.
Oh, that did not age well.
I can't find my voice in my dreams.
Just got chills.
So maybe I don't know.
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 I tip my fucking hat at the new bar, obviously, if you didn't see me, like, crumble the little breadcrumbs over that, but, god damn. Yeah, I can tell a lot of these songs have to do with, like, a lot of human things that humans experience, things about humans, their tendencies, ways that they live, things they go through. You know, mind, state of mind, like a lot of these things have like expectations, feelings, like it's quite literally, the name of it is the only way I can explain it, it's the human condition. Woke the fuck up, I've heard this song too, not enough to know it well, I only know that last night I woke the fuck up, that's like the most I know from this song.
Take your clothes and rip them off.
Oh?
Call these hoes and tip them off. You can tell them you are mine. I'm sick of games. No more time, you lit the litter flame. We live in an age where everything is staged, where all we do is fake our feelings. I've been scared to put myself so out there. Time is running out, yeah. Need to let you know that last night I woke the fuck up. I realized I need you here, as desperate as that sounds. Last night I woke the fuck up. I realized I need you here, as desperate
like that.
As that sounds. Yeah, yeah.
Take these that like rush. Those sound effects after he says woke the fuck up. It kind of sounds like a sudden realization happening in the song.
We live in an age where
slow it down.
Everything is staged and all we do is fake out feelings. I'm so scared to put myself so out there. Time is running out, yeah. Need to let you know.
Straight up, like, all the lyrics are pretty blunt. It's kind of just like, hey, I was stupid. Miss you. You want to come over and put our beds next to each other in Minecraft? Track 8. Overwhelming.
Yeah, I think I got one.
Her soul is presidential like Barack, son. Yeah, she call me Goose, I call her Maverick, cause her Top Gun. They say we annoying, they just jealous cause we got love.
Fucking love Top Gun.
Yeah, I got a hot one. She don't want no problem if there's not one. But people come around and try some stupid shit to start one. She give you the people's fucking elbow like the rock, son.
Yeah.
There is a potion in your lips, so sweet.
I know this song.
There is an ocean in your hips, so deep. I die. I hear an opus when we kiss that completes my life. Yeah, I think I got one. And every single little thing about her is so
I hear an opus when we kiss that completes my life. That's love.
Thing about her is so
that's some real shit. That's not some like phony love song on the radio lyric. That's real. That's something he thought of and was like, pen to paper, brain to pen to paper. That was just cute all the way through. Nice little love song. Some little innuendos in there. Shimmy, track 9. This is Weight of the World. It's got a feature. This is Weight of the World featuring Black Keys.
We're 6 feet underground inside my bed. We're spelling suicide, but not by choice.
What?
Was calling out for help, but heard no noise. No noise. Only the sound of my back breaking. But ever since you and your arms saved me, I don't hold the weight of the world anymore.
Damn.
I had war black and red. The darker instruments inside my head. We're playing suicide, but not by choice, by choice, yeah. Was calling out for help, but heard no noise, noise.
Oh, only the piano.
The sound of my hands shaking.
There's no drums. That's so fucking unique. Jesus. This one's going in. What instrument is that? It kind of sounds like if a saxophone and like an automaton had a baby. It's beautiful. It's really personal too. Like he's got those moments in which he can do those funny little raps with movie references, but he can also get really deep and personal just like that on the next track and have it still flow without it contrasting too hard. Another purgatory moment. Holy shit, that was about the first time something that shouldn't have fit got to me. Usually when like there's some weird ass switch up in one of his songs, I've always been like,
I wish it was a little bit smoother. I don't really like that it's not smooth transitions.
But with that one, it's like this deep, personal, slow song about pressure. And then just boom, rap. Like, it had the same themes, but like sonically, entirely a different thing. And it just swooped in. Like, there was no indication that it was going to be. It wasn't like a. That I noticed. It was just kind of like. Like, out of nowhere. On track 10, this song is called The Good in Me.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, that's synth. That's nice.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Honestly, I'm kind of getting Muse vibes from this. Like, the second law.
You know that he trusts you, and I know that he loves you, but somehow you convince me again. Like a knife in the woods, yeah, you hunt down the good in me.
Damn.
Like a knife in the woods,
that line.
Yeah, you hunt down the good in me.
Jesus, that's so fucking creative.
In the woods, yeah, you hunt down the good in me. One temptation sparked this, now I can feel the darkness. It's my own fault, but you had this planned.
All of your good is mine.
Oh.
Oh. All of your good is mine.
I'm on the moon right now. In my mind, mentally, I'm here. Oh, I was even preparing for like a big drop. Oh. Oh, that was cold. That was cold as hell. That was really cold. Queen does that on the song Too Much Love Will Kill You. They just, the last note is off key. And it makes the ending like, oh fuck, I'm scared. If anyone in the world can compare a song that you write to Queen, it's a compliment. Track 11, Morning in America.
We're secretly out of control, nobody knows it, but my mom. And everyone knows.
Damn.
At the locker, at the locker, at the locker, 7-time release. Heard a lesson. Did he use protection? Doesn't want to keep the baby. Throwing up in the alley, in the alley. Older brother looking for me.
Sir, I was just trying to drink my kombucha.
Out of control, nobody knows me. And my friends all addicted to porn. Can't keep a girlfriend, cause the great expectations got all us imitating. Yeah, we're secretly out of control. And everyone
damn,
knows.
I just said damn, bro. You know how if you can muster up a damn bro out of me. That wasn't my favorite song, if I'm honest. Like, it wasn't bad at all. Like, I just don't know if that's a song I go back to for an extended period of time. And for all I know, that could change upon editing it. Cause that does happen a lot, where I'll hear a song and a reaction and be like, and then I'll hear it again while I'm editing it, and I'm like, why did I not freak out over this song the first listen? What's wrong with me? It mustered up a damn bro, so, again, another win for me. iRobot. Let's use FL Studio. I feel like I've heard a lot of these sounds while I'm making music.
Breathing and thinking, eating and drinking, feeling.
philosophizing. I was a human before you killed me and ripped my heart out. I knew what love was.
Damn, bro.
Now and then
I would just say damn bro again.
I just reply slow robot. Ba 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 boom ba da ba.
He's a robot and also a scat man.
Then you cut me open. Now all that I know is I am a robot. Goodness and empty.
Now all that I know is I am a robot. This is a really creative way to talk about a relationship taking it out of you. Another fucking purgatory moment. I'm still not like accustomed to them. I don't expect them. That's real good. 12 songs in and those like ending purgatory parts still get to me. That is a great sign of a fucking like really well put together album. That was a really creative way to write a song about something that is talked about quite a lot in music, you know, aftermath of a relationship ending. There's countless songs about that, because there are plenty of songs about various things that don't mean anything because they weren't written by a person, they were written by people trying to concoct a song to be successful in a boardroom. But John Bellion, when you listen to his music, you can tell it's coming from him. I've really enjoyed this, but we got two left before we can pass on our final judgments. This is a song I do know. It's got another feature. This is Guillotine featuring Travis Mendez.
Sleep on me.
There's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway. And if you have nightmares, we'll dance on the bed.
That's switch up instrumentally. The flow stayed the same, but the instrumental switched up.
Even when I lose my head, guillotine.
Now it's all just humans. That's cool.
You fill me up, you fill me up, you set my soul ablaze.
That track's always been enjoyable. I really like the line, there's skeletons in my closet. Or there's bones in my closet? I forget what it was. There's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway. And with that explosion, we reached the last track, and thus the longest on the record. This is Hand of God outro. That's real pretty. Ooh.
My head spins, I've been sipping lately.
Ooh.
All my sins, I've been tripping, my God. Brand new life, I've been looking lately. All these nights, they've been cooking me raw. Tears at a funeral, I might break.
This is so good.
Angry at all the things I can't change. When you're lost in the universe, don't lose faith. My mother says your whole life's in the hand of God.
Break it down.
tears at a funeral I might break.
God, this song, I love the chord progression.
Angry at
and I
things,
love the way the melodies and the fucking lyrics, everything about this song is awesome. Jesus. I like that it's not perfectly on beat too. It's human. Humans aren't perfect. The transitions I didn't like. It's not perfect. I don't know if that's what he meant, but that's what's making this make sense.
Tears at a funeral, I might break.
Who is that?
Angry at all the things, angry at all the things I can't change. When you're lost
the strings.
In the universe, lost in the universe, don't lose faith.
That callback. It's like an overture thing happening right now. It's cyclical. It's a cyclical album. I love cyclical albums so much, where they, like, you can just listen to them on repeat and it's a constant transition. That was fucking awesome. That was, in my opinion, a lot better than Glory Sound Prep. I really did enjoy that. And also, I'm sorry for the vertical video. My camera died mid-filming, so I tried to fix that, but it just kept dying. So, now I'm here, but, yeah, that was really fucking good. Really creative, and it was human. Literally, it's in the name. I couldn't think of a more perfect name for that album. Fuck yeah. And before I go, I have a Spotify profile, and you should go follow it, because there's about to be some new music, perhaps. I heard from a little birdie, who shall remain nameless and isn't a bird. Also, my Spotify is slept on. It's severely underrated. Like, it's almost sad. And that's the last thing I want it to be. I don't think anyone likes sad, especially in these times. So let's make some happy, like Bo Burnham, except we're actually happy. So please, make my Spotify profile a beautiful man this Christmas. And listen to it. With that said, I won't see you in the next video, but you'll see me. Guillotine.